माउंटेन्स एंड वैलीज आर ए पार्ट ऑफ लिविंग, गोइंग थ्रू देम स्माइलिंगली इज द आर्ट ऑफ लिविंग, राइट? एंड साइलेंस इज टचिंग योर गॉड विद इन यू. साइलेंस प्रिवेंट्स प्रॉब्लम्स, स्माइल सॉल्व्स प्रॉब्लम्स. When I say silence, I don't mean that she is scolding you and the boss is harassing you and you're just keeping quiet. I'm silent. Inside the chatterbox is going on. You're not silent. No, there's not silence. Silence is you feel very quiet from within. Outside, you may be speaking and yelling. Inside, you're very silent. That is silence I'm talking about. So meditation is the way to reach that silence. Outside you are yapping, yelling. Inside you are silent. I'm talking about that silence. Okay. So what we'll do now is, instead of me talking, we'll have different steps. We'll just segregate. And especially people who have come with their family members or friends, please, don't be near each other. Okay? Because something's going to happen, you're going to say something, don't do like this. After mama is mama, no? Arman, you'll fall down. You just can't stop yourself. Right? We are amongst nature and see the weather has changed, now it's beautiful. So you just go here and there. Just whatever you feel like doing, just do. Walk, sit. Lot of places to enjoy here. Just be with yourself. And simply be aware, how are you feeling? If you are feeling very good, don't crave for it. Next time, that goodness will not happen. If you are feeling anxious, don't hate it, because that is also temporary. So whatever you experience, just go through this. Some of you will start feeling very relaxed, very happy immediately. Nothing very great about you. Don't say my relaxation is better than your relaxation. Okay? Or my silence is better than your silence. There's no comparison. Some of you will find that suddenly you start feeling very anxious, very disturbed. Whatever you have been suppressing suddenly comes to the front. It's just like putting your clothes in the washing machine. First wash is very dirty. I didn't go anywhere. I just wore the skirt in the morning and the shirt and the pant in the morning. So dirty. You don't realize you are accumulating so much of dust. Similarly, although you might say I am a very happy, well-adjusted person, but you are accumulating lot of garbage. So first wash is very dirty. Second wash is very dirty. It takes some time for the dirt to clear off. So if you feel anxious or some anger is coming, some disturbance is coming, go through this. This is also temporary. Wait it out. This is very important. Don't come running to me. Sir, I'm feeling like this. Papa. See, he's disturbing me. I said the same thing. Go through this. Sir, I'm feeling very disappointed. Be more disappointed. Go through it. Don't reject it. Because that's what life is giving that moment. Because you are a human being, you are going to have all the emotions. All the emotions. Good, bad, ugly, beautiful. All will happen to you, each one of you, whatever your spiritual level. Please understand, for the last 20 years I am into meditation and teaching people. I have my own sets of emotions, same like yours. Exactly same thing I feel. In fact, we feel more than you feel, more sensitive. But when it comes, go through it, disappears. We don't reject it. Something good happens, we don't become attached to it. This is also temporary. So everything is temporary. One sentence. Resistance leads to persistence. If you resist that disappointment, that sadness, that frustration, that ugliness, that anxiety, you keep on persisting in your life. By stopping it, you are giving energy to it. It. I want to forget it. It. It is there. You are giving energy to it. Let it come and go. This is temporary. His own quota. Maybe 5 minutes. Maybe 5 hours. You don't know. You just have to go through it. If something good happens, again, is temporary. Resistance leads to persistence. Acceptance leads to disappearance. Just accept that emotion, that thought, angry, frustrated, sad, mad, bad, but not glad. Welcome. Come more. Quota will be over very soon. Acceptance leads to disappearance with negative emotions. Now here the definition must be very, very clear. Negative emotion, when I use the word, I'm not using in the normal way. Negative emotion is that emotion which disappears with witnessing. It was negative in your life at that moment. Good emotion is that emotion, that feeling, which increases with witnessing. That's the definition. If this emotion is useful for you in that moment, it will expand. Fill up your whole being. That time it is good for you. For example, you are going on the road with your wife and somebody comes and threatens you. Your honor is at stake, your money is at stake. At that time you have to become angry. That time you cannot say, see, I am into meditation. And don't talk to me like this, be sweet. Let's be courteous. At that time it's a question of your honor. You have to be angry. And you will see that anger is very useful. So with witnessing, the anger will expand in that moment. It's good for you. Next day, this will contract, vanish. So you become the master of your anger. Anger is not your master. Right now, what is happening in your life is, you are so logical people. You are very educated people like me. Since you are very educated. Yeah, educated. The meaning of education is to draw from within. That's the basic meaning of education. To draw the God from within. What is being taught to us is superimposed from outside. So what we are getting is not education basically. With your education, your master, the God within you, is sleeping. The real you is sleeping. So the logical mind, which is the watchman basically, starts pretending, I am the master. The logical mind, when it becomes a master, it is a very bad master. All the tensions, all the worries, all the problems of your life are only because of this reason, that your real master is sleeping. You are really sleeping, the spiritual self, and the conscious mind, which is a servant, a watchman, has become a master, a fictitious master. And this is going to have arguments, debates, discussions, fights, tensions, worries. Is the property of conscious mind. So when the servant starts to become a master, going to be complications. So meditation is the way, ATM. Any time meditation. All time meditation, ATM, awaken the master. So conscious mind comes in its own place. I am a humble servant, I am a watchman. What's my command, sir? That's all. It's a very good tool. Very good watchman to be used as a tool. Problem comes, it becomes your master. Very important point, conscious mind will be always confused. There is nothing called clarity of mind. Conscious mind cannot be clear. Clarity occurs only when you are in the super conscious mind. So wherever you are crystal clear, which happens very rarely, at that time you are touching the super conscious. There is nothing called concentration of mind. Conscious mind cannot be concentrated. It's like a wind blowing from here to there, the monsoon. Concentration happens only when you touch the super conscious. Meditation is not concentration. But concentration improves as a byproduct of meditation. You are not your shadow. But shadow belongs to you. But you are not the shadow. So concentration is the shadow of meditation. Getting this? So never think that I have to concentrate on my breath, I have to concentrate on my thought, nothing. You just have to be aware. Concentration means I am focusing on 1% and neglecting 99%. It is very tiring, very exhausting. You are fighting with yourself. Because the conscious mind has to go from here to here. Clouds in the sky. Can't be tight. Very difficult. Don't even try it. You are going to fail. Come into meditation. All the chatterbox of your mind stops. The useless thoughts stop. Automatically, You're touching the super conscious. Concentration happens as a byproduct. Got the idea? So meditation is not concentration. Don't make this mistake ever. Be aware of everything which is happening moment to moment. Remember, happiness is moment to moment. So here, before we disperse, I'll give you one small tip. Three things we are doing in our life. We are chasing health, wealth, relationships. The triangle. Health, wealth, relationships. And they all take time to develop. They require nurturing, gardening. Never happens in one day. So whether you're spending time in gathering health, gathering wealth, or nurturing a relationship, be total into that moment. What happens as a byproduct is happiness in that moment. So this is the triangle. Health, wealth, relationships. You follow them totally into that moment without any judgment. Enjoy it. It becomes a pyramid. Top is the happiness. Happiness always happens in the present moment. That we already seen. How? Pursuing whatever you are pursuing totally. Happiness is always a byproduct. You can never catch it directly. You can never improve upon it. It is never in the future. It's right now. So if you're not happy right now, you will not be happy tomorrow also. Impossible. It's very important to realize happiness is right now. Whatever you are doing, whatever actions you are doing, thoroughly enjoy it. Whatever emotions going through, go through it totally. What happens as a byproduct is sudden flowering of happiness. So whatever you are experiencing in this moment, next moment, next moment, go through it willingly. Experience it totally. What happens is happiness as a byproduct. There is no other way. Happiness is right now. You are sitting. This is happiness. If you are totally aware of your body, really accepting what's happening, you are happy. So whether you are sad or glad, both are a part of happiness. Sadness also is a part of happiness. Gladness also is a part of happiness. If there's a mountain, there will be a valley. If there's a valley, there will be a mountain. Both are a part of happiness. Okay? So right now when you go, you may feel good, may not feel good. Accept it. Willingly welcome. That's all is required. This is the beginning, this is the end. If you can do this, you said enlightenment like this. Chutki mein. So easy. So let's experience it. Okay? Then I'll show you more ways, deeper ways to be in the present moment at any moment. Any questions you want to ask? Anything you want to ask, you can ask right now. Once you disperse, no questions. No talking to anybody, no eye contact, just be with yourself. Time limit.